Welcome children, this is your social class. Today we are going to discuss about a new lesson. Our new lesson name is the treeless and grassland. The treeless grassland. Children, in this new chapter is explain what is treeless grassland and what do you mean by grassland and what is the importance of this vegetation, lifestyle, which are the animals are living and what is the climate condition and everything we are going to study in this lesson. So children, in your textbook first you can see one activity, that is get started. You can see one activity, get started, that is you want to wheat producing region. So how much do you know about wheat and circle the correct answer in each. Okay, so wheat is food or cash crops, that's we are already study. I think your fourth standard you are already studied that wheat is a cash crops or food crop. Yes, that is which one? That is food crop. Okay, and the second one is Tamil Nadu or Punjab is the largest wheat producing state in India. Nammude Indiayile edaanu Tamil Nadu or Punjab is the largest wheat producing states. So that is the answer is Punjab. And third question, wheat grows best in cool and moist or hot and wet climate. Okay, so which climate is suitable to cultivate wheat? So which is the answer children? That is hot and wet climate. Fourth one is north or south India is largely a wheat consuming region. So that is north. Okay, so south is in our side. So okay children, so which fourth answer is north or south is which side is more or largely wheat consuming state or wheat consuming region, that is northern side. Okay, so this all activity or this get started activity is coming to based on your fourth standard one chapter is there our agriculture. Have you remember children that chapter? So in that chapter we have studied that which are the cash crops, which are the food crops, and in that area which state is more cultivated wheat, rice, maize, these type of food items. So this get started activity also based in fourth standard textbook. Okay, so tell me children, what is grassland? What do you mean by grassland? So grassland means grassland are large plains of grass, that area full of covered with grass. Okay, there is only we can see long type of grass and shrubs. Okay, kuttichedigalum grass porulla long type of grass only we can see in that region. Okay, so that place we called grassland. Okay, there is no trees and there is no other forest and everything. Why there is no big trees and there is no forest and all? Because they are getting very less rainfall. Okay, so that is grassland. What is grassland? That is grassland are a large plains of grass and they're full of covered with long grasses and shrubs. Okay children, and children, in this area we can see only grasses and we can't see long trees and forest, everything. The reason is only they are getting very less rainfall. Okay, and this area is also we can see the temperate zone. Okay, that is a most of the grassland are in temperate zone. So temperate zone we are already study in the previous classes. Three zones are the torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. So in this area we can mostly found in which zone? That is temperate zone. So temperate zone is what happened? Temperate zone they are getting very that average, the average of they are receiving sunlight, and so that area also the climate is cold, and sometimes it's cold and hot. So that is temperate zone. So this area also receive rain, receive sun rays also. Okay, and they are known by different names in different countries. So, and also this area, this type of area in different countries known as different names. Okay, so one of the name is prairies. Prairies is the one of the name is, that is also you can see in your map, that is page number 167, you can see one map is there, that is in United States of America. United States of America, in that region it's calling that land or that region is calling prairies. Okay children, have you understood? So in United States of America, in that places, this type of region is called prairies. Okay, prairies means, prairie, it's a French word. Prairies, it's a French word. It's mean grassland. Okay, it's the meaning of grassland. Prairies, it's a meaning of grassland. It's a French word and it's located in United States of America. Okay, and the prairies are a vast stretch of gently sloping temperate grassland in North America. So from in which side? That is in temperate grassland in North America. Okay children, and its location, its location from where to where, its location is extended from Canada in the north to Mexico to south. Okay, Canada in north to Mexico in the south. Okay, so from where to where this prairies area is extended, the prairies is extended in from where? Canada in the north and Mexico in the south. Okay children, and it's cover whole part of the USA. It's cover whole part of the USA. This is the importance of location. And the next one is the importance of land. What is the importance of land in this region? Okay, that is the prairies were once covered with thick and tall grasses. We are already telling that what is grassland. We can see mostly we can see long type of grass, we can see that is also covered with, it's a covered with thick and tall grasses. But at the long years back we can see like that, but nowadays they are making to cultivate, and they are making to they are using that land and to make fertile soil in this region. Okay, and also important to thing is that two rivers are flowing from there, that is Mississippi and Missouri. That's important answer is that which are the rivers, two big rivers that flow through this region, which region? That is prairies region. So in this region two rivers are flowing through this region, that the name is Mississippi and Missouri. Okay, Mississippi and Missouri, these two rivers are flowing through this prairies region. Okay children, so we are discussed what is the importance of location and what is the importance of land. Now the next is we are going to explain the importance of climate. We are already telling that the climate condition is this prairies area mostly we can found in temperate zone. So temperate zone area, it's which type of climate children? That is sometime it's hot and sometime it's cold, and winters are cold and summers are hot. It's that type of climate. And also rainfall is also moderate. Okay, moderate rainfall also they are receiving from this region, and about 52 to 70 centimeter, it's mostly in and occurs mostly in summer season. Okay, so the important thing is the climate condition is winter season is they are in cold region, and the summer season is very hot region. Okay, this is the climate of prairies region. And the next one is the importance of vegetation. Which type of animals are living from there and what is that vegetation? What is the condition of the vegetation from this region? The wide variety of plants grow in this region. Plants, not a trees. The variety types of plants are growing in this region, and trees are also, we can see rarely we can see the trees and all. നമുക്ക് ഒട്ടും ഇല്ല എന്നുള്ള ഒരു അവസ്ഥയിലേക്കല്ല, but mostly we can see full of covered with grass. Okay, but some cases, sometimes rarely we can see some trees. And expect along the rivers, and grass grow quickly during the spring season. That is the importance of their season. In the which season? The spring season. The spring season, the grass and everything is speedily to grow, and after that, this grass and all to making hay in autumn season. Okay, hay in autumn season. Hay means adellam endai marum, that grass and everything is making dry grass. Okay, ee vaikole pole aavunu parayile, so that's become dry. Okay, so that is the importance of their season. In spring season, the every grass and everything is growing speedily, and the autumn season, that's become make a hay and that's become dry. Okay, that is the importance of vegetation. And the next is the importance of wildlife. Which type of animals are we can see from there? That is some four animals pictures to given in your textbook. These are the animals we can see from there. That is, first one is bison, second one is prairie's dog, third one is prairie's chicken, and fifth one is toyote. Okay, these are the animals mostly we can found in this region, and the animals that live here adapted themselves to the in this region also. So animals also living from there, and also we can mostly seen this type of animals. Okay children, and the next one is, what is the importance of economic condition of this region? Economic condition, so that is, we are already explaining that land is long years back, it's full of covered with grass. Then after that, they are using that land, and to cultivate the land, that's become to make a soil is fertile soil. So that's also they are cultivating the crops from there. The mostly they are cultivating the crops are wheat. Okay, mostly they are cultivating the crops are wheat. That's also farmers produce enough wheat. Farmers produce enough wheat from the wool of the country. Wool of the country, the farmers are producing this wheat and to exporting the other country also. Okay, the farmers are producing enough wheat, wool of the country, and exporting the another country also. That's why also, that is the reason the prairies, this region, it's called wheat basket of the world. Okay, that is the important question. Why the prairies is called wheat basket of the world? Okay, why? Because the farmers are produce enough wheat and in the wool country, and to exporting other country also. That's why they are calling prairies region is calling what? That is wheat basket of the world. Okay children, read your textbook proper, study these important points also. Thank you.